In today's video, I am going to explain muscle anatomy around first rib, and I will explain why first rib is important place. This is where first rib is. This is the most superior part of ribcage, right? It's literally first rib, the most superior part. Oh, by the way, you do not see clavicle in this picture because clavicle and first rib are very close. If I keep clavicle in this part, you don't see muscles around first rib. So let me explain muscle anatomy first. You see this muscle? This is neck muscle. This is scalene. Scalene. There are three fibers in scalene and two fibers attached to first rib. This one is anterior fiber. Anterior, and this one is middle fiber. Anterior and middle fiber. See these two fibers attached to first rib. This muscle is important for neck muscle and breathing. If this muscle is used chronically, that keeps bringing up ribcage this way and this is stuck. So that might create for neck pain, tight neck, and for tight ribcage. This is very important muscle. Let's go to next one. Next one is this one. This is actually shoulder girdle muscle. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. See, this muscle also attaches to first rib right here. So when this guy gets tight, that usually inhibits scapular movement. Yes, this is very important muscle for scapular movement and scapular stabilization. However, look at that. This one attaches to first rib. So when this muscle gets tight, that may inhibit movement of ribcage. If ribcage moves, what's going to happen? That is breathing and trunk rotation. So ribcage is important for breathing and trunk rotation. If serratus anterior gets tight, that may inhibit breathing and trunk movement, very important muscle. Let's go to a little bit inferior part from first rib. You see these muscles? These muscles are in between ribcage, in between ribs. So this is intercostalis. Intercostalis. There are three layers in intercostalis muscles. First one is external. External intercostalis. Next one, internal. Internal intercostalis. The last one is innermost intercostalis. Innermost intercostalis. Again, there are three layers among intercostalis muscles. Of course, that attaches to first rib right here. When first rib doesn't move, these muscles cannot move very well. Then what's going to happen? Breathing is restricted. So this is very important place. Then I said clavicle is hidden in this picture. Let's look at clavicle. This is clavicle. You see clavicle here. See, you don't see scalene and other muscles right here. You see another muscle right here. This is subclavius. Subclavius. This is literally below clavicle. Look at here. This is first rib. This muscle kind of connects first rib and clavicle like this. When this muscle gets tight, that brings first rib up and clavicle down. Oh, by the way, this is medial part of clavicle. Clavicle has articulation with sternum. Articulation means joint. Plus, there's ligament that connects first rib and clavicle. See, this is very compact area, very busy area. Thus, clavicle, sternum, and first rib have very strong, close relationship. If clavicle doesn't move, first rib doesn't move. If first rib doesn't move, clavicle doesn't move. Very busy area. Then, there are muscles attaching to first rib on posterior part of body. Let's look at that. So this is posterior view. I want to explain two muscles. This one, this is part of erector spinae. But which fiber attaches to first rib? This is iliocostalis thoracis. iliocostalis thoracis. Main function of erector spinae is extension of trunk. Extension of trunk. This is kind of a thin fiber among erector spinae, but still, this one attaches to first rib. So when this guy gets tight, it's hard to move trunk, don't you think? Plus, this is rib cage. You know, rib cage, what happens if this muscle gets tight? Maybe that inhibits breathing. So, actually, back muscles attach to rib cage, so they are not only back muscles, they are also breathing muscle. Very important thing. Next one is also back muscle, well, kind of back muscle. This is it. This is levator costrum. Levator costrum, particularly, I want to focus on the shorter one. This is levator costrum brevis. Levator costrum brevis. Brevis kind of originates from C7. C7 and attaches to first rib. However, you don't see the fiber, but if you look carefully, there is fiber from C7 to rib 1. This is tiny muscle, very tiny muscle. However, tiny muscle is important. Tiny muscle cannot exert a lot of power like big muscle. However, tiny muscles are important for joint stability. When these muscles cannot move, ribcage cannot move. If ribcage cannot move, what's going to happen? Breathing in is restricted. Simple, right? So these are main muscles attaching around first rib. But why is first rib important? It's not only the breathing place. This is very important kind of an intersection among spines. Let me explain that. This is where first rib is, and this is where first thoracic spine is. Question, what is above thoracic spine 1? What is above T1? That is C7. C7, cervical spine 7. Then, what does cervical mean? That is neck. Then, what is thoracic mean? That is chest, thorax, right? Thus, T1 and C7 is kind of intersection between neck and chest or thorax. Right, intersection between neck and thorax. And first rib is from T1. That makes sense. Ribcage is from thoracic spines. Rib 1 originates from T1. That is why this is very important intersection between ribcage and cervical spines. So what if this intersection gets tight? Maybe breathing is restricted because this is part of thorax. Or maybe neck movement is restricted because this is part of neck. Does it make sense? So what happens if muscles around first rib gets tight, such as scalene, subclavius, or like intercostalis, erector spinae, levator costrum? When these muscles get tight, that inhibits movement of first rib. Very important intersection. Then what's going to happen? Neck and thorax cannot move very well. Of course, breathing can be restricted, but also neck movement, thoracic movement can be restricted as well. By the way, there is another intersection below thoracic spines. You don't see from this picture, but let's imagine this is T12. This is the most inferior part of thoracic spines. What is below T12? There is L1, lumbar spine 1. So this is also intersection between different segments. Below this segment, there is lumbar spines and abdominal area. Above this intersection, there is thoracic spines, ribcage, and internal organs. What kind of internal organs inside of thorax? There is heart, there is lung, there is thoracic esophagus. Many important internal organs are inside of thorax. Again, this is important intersection between thorax and neck. How can you apply today's anatomy for daily activity, yoga, Pilates, exercise, athletic performance? Well, if you focus on first rib and related muscles, you bring intention around here, then you may have better breathing, better stretching, better athletic performance, because having visualization of anatomy is important to enhance athletic performance, stretching performance, and yoga practice. That is why anatomy is freaking important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.